Storm clouds are building above the timberline. The lightning's flashing across the mountainside. Thunder's rolling down the canyons of his mind. Somewhere beyond the Great Divide. The bugle of the bull elk echoes through the pines. The north wind moans her lonesome lullaby. He hungers for the freedom of an eagle as she glides. Somewhere beyond the Great Divide.
Okay, Dan here from Hardwood Hollow's Beyond Bushcraft Skills channel, and today I'm bringing you a little bit of a gear review. I've got a selection of different utility knives, most of them from Stanley, and then one other. I just wanted to give a quick review. Some of these are new products, some are older products, and give you my thoughts and impressions on them. So let's reset the video and we'll start the tabletop review. Okay. First up, and my oldest one, is this one right here. This one is fairly unique. It's obviously it's a full-size unit. It has your normal slide-out utility blade, but additionally you flip it over and on the outside it has a thumb stud activated folding knife with a serrated edge. This is made from 420 stainless. So it's not great stainless, but it's decent stainless. Kind of an interesting thing is that the thumb stud actually rotates. It is a liner lock style. So you retract the lock, you can close it, and then thumb stud it open. So it is kind of deep to get into the thumb stud in this hole right here. So it's a little bit more difficult to get a good flip on it. So normally, you are going to have to open it quickly, give yourself a little opening and a wrist snap, and it opens right up. Fairly easy blade change. You push this up to the stopping position here, and then you can actually push it down and slide it just a tiny bit further forward. You come up and you hold on that button, and that allows you to push this yellow button right here. So you come up and you push that yellow button right there, you reach from the top, and the blade comes right out, and then it slides back in when you're depressing on that yellow button, and it slides back in, locks in position, and then you can retract it. So there's that one. It includes a sheath, which actually has a little bit of a stiffener inside of it for it to fit into, and the sheath has onboard extra blade storage, and then it closes with a Velcro flap, and it's got your standard belt loop on the back. Decent quality. This one rides in my truck all the time. I've had that probably 15 years now. It's a decent one. I don't use it a whole lot, but it's just a cutting utensil I have in the truck should I ever need it. Second, we're going to go over, it's a Chinese made one. I picked it up at my local hardware store. It's nothing special. It's pretty ruggedly built overall. These slab sides are aluminum. It was blue anodized before, but whoever was marketing it when I bought it has actually hydro dipped it. I've seen a couple of versions of it online of the same thing, one with plastic handles and then others with the metal, the aluminum handles. They were being marketed in Europe. One problem I did have with it is these three screws on the clip kept coming loose. So the last time I took it apart and fixed it, I actually affixed the clip itself with some epoxy, and then used epoxy on the screws also, and it hasn't come loose since. And this is a slide style, so it fits tip down, and you pull it out and you push the slide lever on the top, and it allows the knife to slide. And then you have this roller wheel, and this roller wheel, you pull it towards you, and the blade slides out very easily, and then slides back in. If for any reason you need it longer, you can actually catch that first slot on the top of the blade, which will leave the blade out longer. However, when you retract it, the blade sticks out just a tiny bit. So you do need to make sure, if you do need the blade longer and you use the longer setting, to reset the blade back to its normal length, and then you can retract it. This one caught my eye last year. I bought this one in California. It's from Stanley. It's the Fat Max line, and it also, this one is a flip open. Now, if you open it slowly, it is a liner lock, and that liner lock does not engage very far. So what I have learned to do with this one is when I open it part way, and I give it a snap, and that liner lock then engages almost halfway over, and it's locked good and solid. Now this one has a similar unlocking method to the slide that I showed you, except this time you roll the wheel forward and the blade slides out the end and then slides back in, and that bar right there, you'll see it retract, and that's what locks the blade in place. It does have the pocket clip on it. This is a single screw. The rotating, hinge bolt is what holds the clip in place. This one does have one other unique feature on it. This back part is actually rubberized, so it gives you it's a little bit more grippy. And then on the back here, you see that little button right there. You push that button down like this, and it releases that rubberized back. And see that red in there? That gives you additional onboard storage of blades. And we'll take the blade out of this one real quick and show you. That red is kind of like a magazine indicator. When an extra blade is in here, you cannot see that red. And there's a spring clip to hold the blade in place to keep it from moving around. So now when you look in there, you see the blade, and it's in there safely. When it's open, the blade's not accessible to any kind of cutting from the inside. It's safely up here in the frame, but when you want it out, make sure the knife is closed, push that button down, lift that back up, and now you can see the top of the blade sticking up there, and then you just pull the blade out and replace it as needed. And then that's that. So the other feature this one came with, which I ground off of here, is right here at the front on this side right there. Get it to focus. You can see that little bit of silver right there. It actually stuck out about a quarter of an inch, and that's part of the inside frame you can see there. And it stuck out about a quarter of an inch, and what it was there for was a package opener to cut package tape with. The problem is that it carries tip down, and that was pointing up. So when it was in my pocket, a number of times I stuck myself on that. One time, even going to reach in my pocket, I caught it with my fingernail and shoved that little blade up under my nail and decided, okay, that sucker's gone. So a little work on the on it with the belt sander and the polishing wheel, and we took care of it, and that has not been a problem since. We'll go ahead and put this blade back in for safety. Okay, moving on. Now these I just picked up today. They're brand new products in the Stanley line. This one, the first thing that caught my eye on this one and why I picked it up initially was made in USA. That's a huge deal for me. And it's a slider type, similar to this one, only it's lighter weight. It's skeletonized somewhat. And if you look where my finger was, it has a carabiner, so you can clip it onto things, hang it from things. And it also has a pocket clip right here. Now, like I was saying about this one and it having the package opener, this one has that as well. So that little hook right there, is the package opener. I'm not sure exactly what these two little claw style hooks are for, but I honestly have plans of taking them off. This has one screw right here, and when you undo that screw, it allows all of this to come off, and you're left with just the utility knife. Now, you cannot operate it without that on there, because this is the back side of the frame. But I can take it off, remove these two sharp points, because again, when the pocket clip is used, it's, in this case, it's tip up, but you have those points facing up, which I don't like, so they're going to go. I'm assuming, possibly, that these are to use it as some kind of a cord cutter, but honestly, the blade goes the wrong way, so I don't know how that would work, and the packaging doesn't give any detail of any kind other than how to change the blade right here. That's the only instructions on it. Oh, I stand corrected. I just saw it. That's actually a bottle opener. So since I almost always have my Leatherman on me and or my Swiss Army knife, that doesn't matter, so that bottle opener hook is coming off, and the package hook. But now this one, like I said, it's a slider, so it slides out. As you would expect, it has multiple stop points. That's the first stop point. Second, now that's what it's considered fully open. However, to change the blade, you go one spot out to its complete opening. Now you're going to reach up here and grab the blade this way. I'm going to show you on this side, there's a button right here. So what you do is you depress that button, push it over to the right, and it allows the blade to slide out so you can remove the blade safely. I recommend sliding the blade back in until you meet resistance, and then you push that button again and let it go all the way in. I always recommend giving a little tug to make sure it's locked in, like that, and then you close it. But there you go, nice, lightweight, has a little carabiner on it. As far as the bottle opener part goes, I actually would have preferred if they would have done the Leatherman style, where on the Leatherman style, the carabiner, unless it's patented for some reason, this is my Leatherman mutt. This is the bottle opener right here on the Leatherman, and it's part of the carabiner. So this, what would have happened is this hook right here would have been the bottle opener, but I guess in the case of this folding knife, or utility knife rather, that would have been more difficult because of the metal that this is made out of being some sort of alloy, pot metal of some kind, aluminum alloy or something. It feels too heavy to be aluminum, so I'm guessing it's some kind of a steel zinc alloy. But anyway, so that knife, 100% made in the USA. I also picked up some new blades while I was down there because I was out of blades. This is a 15 pack, and surprisingly enough, also made in the USA. And last but not least, this is their newest one. Now you'll notice it's thicker yet than this one, which was pretty thick, this Fat Max, and it's thick also. It does have the pocket clip, and it's got pretty good spring to it. I would be cautious using the pocket clip though, because it's not as thick as I think it could be, but you know, it is what it is. Here's this utility knife's really unique feature. It opens. Now, when it opens, it does not open with the blade out. So, because of that, it's not considered a switchblade. They call it a spring assist, is what they call it. But because the blade does not automatically deploy when you push the button and spring it open, it's not considered a switchblade. Now, at this point, you'll grab it normally and slide the blade out. And again, it has, as all, almost all Stanleys do, it has multiple positions, 1, 2, and 3 fully out. This one also gives you a little rubber nub right here, and that nub can be used if you need to choke up on it to put down pressure. It feels pretty comfortable. This back piece also is rubberized as it was on the other model. It does not have any onboard blade storage. That's a little disappointing to me. The clip, the spring steel clip, wraps over the top. It's held in with that one screw. Now this screw right here is not necessary. It was there. It actually went through this hole, and the knife was actually bolted. It was actually bolted this way on the package, and the screw came through the back and went into that hole. But when I saw where it went, right below the spring clip, I figured having that little nub below the spring clip will only add a little bit to make it stick better in your pocket. So again, you push the button to close it. I guess it needs a little bit of break-in time, but push the button to open it, slide the blade forward, and then to change the blade on this one, you see that red button? That's very similar to this one with its yellow button, where you have to push the button, as I showed you, to change the blade. So in this case, with the blade in the out position, grasp the blade above the cutting edge, put your finger on the red button, depress it, and the blade will slide out the end. And then again, like I said before, slide it in until it stops. Push the button again until it goes all the way in. And then it'll close. And then you have to push the release button, which is the same button to open it and close it. And that'll close it. And then you push the button again to get it to open. So I'm sure, like I said, I literally just bought this today, just a few hours ago. So I'm sure it'll take a little bit of break-in time to get it past whatever it's sticking on in there. I'm not sure what it's sticking on or why it's sticking, but we'll get that worked out. We have just about 4 1/2 closed. And then we'll open it. Open and without the blade extended. Here, we'll put it on top of the easier there. It's 6 3/4. And with the blade fully extended, it's 7 1/4. So 7 1/4 overall on this one with the blade extended. And right at just really just 4 inches. 4 1/4 inches when it's closed. The slider that I showed you closed is 4 1/2. Fully extended, it's 6. The Fat Max here is 4 1/4 closed. And that one is 6 3/4 open. Now we got this guy, and that is 7 inches closed with the utility blade fully extended. You're at 7 1/2, and with this blade extended, which for the record, this blade is 3 1/4 inch in cutting length, and the overall is 10 1/4 with that blade open. And then we have the compact slider, and the compact slider, since that steel is going to come off, I'm just going to give you the measurement without the steel, or with the steel, we'll go to the full measurement. And that one is, actually this one's going to measure it easier from this side. And that one is 4 4¾. That's 4¾ closed. And then if you go to this is the standard, like I said, the standard open position. And in the standard open position, you're right at 6. So there you go. That's the tabletop review. After I've used these two for a little while, the two newest Stanleys that I just bought, I'll get them in frame here. After I do get some use on these, we might come back and do a secondary review. So there you go. That's your Stanley FatMax Spring Assist and your Stanley Quick Slide Utility Knives. Again, remember the Quick Slide is 100% made in the USA. This FatMax was, the Spring Assist was Taiwan, I believe. Thailand, I'm sorry. And this one, I believe, was Korea, I think. It doesn't say on it, and I don't have the packaging anymore, but I'm pretty sure that the original packaging listed this one as Korean made. This one I know is Chinese made. This one's not listed anywhere on it, on the blades or anything, so it's not likely Chinese, so it's probably Taiwan or something like that. I have no idea. Again, I don't have the packaging for this one either. The sheath, I think, had a tag that said China, but it's gone now. So there you go. There's your utility knife review. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you next time. Again, this is Dan from Hardwood Hollow's Beyond Bushcraft Skills Channel.
Storm clouds are building above the timberline. The lightning's flashing across the mountainside. Thunder's rolling down the canyons of his mind. Somewhere beyond the Great Divide. The bugle of the bull elk echoes through the pines. The north wind moans her lonesome lullaby. He hungers for the freedom of an eagle as she glides somewhere beyond the Great Divide. He's heard the call of the wild. He's heard the call of the wild. The mountains call him to him like a mother calls her child. He's heard the call of the wild.